We accomplished fission yesterday. Today we're shooting for chemical reactions, and the result could be terrifying. Cue the intro. Hey guys, what's good? Rising Phoenix One. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are. Hey, this video is presented by the EA Creator Network, and a shout out to the EA Community Manager Kits, because he's the one who got us these cards. All right. So yesterday we went through the promo, did all that. Yesterday's video will be linked in the end screen of this video. We played with this lineup here on the fission side, and today we're going to be playing with this lineup here on the chemical reaction side. What's the result of that? 2-1-18 overall Grandmasters Jimmy Butler and Karl Anthony Towns. We looked at the stats of all these cards in yesterday's video, so we're just going to take a very quick look at these five guys, because this is who we're going to play with today. Tyrese Haliburton, some interesting athleticism stats, good inside, decent perimeter, and not bad defense or playmaking. Zach LaVine, who's gonna have a +4 to inside and outside scoring from his own boost. Pretty decent rebounding, good inside offensive game, terrific perimeter shooting game, and a fairly good defensive game as well. Jaren Jackson Jr., decent rebounding, very good offensive game, and some pretty darn good defense. Clint Capella, really big vertical and rebounding, terrific looking inside offensive game, and at least some defense coming from him. And then we get to the GM that we're gonna use today, Jimmy Butler, who's got a +6 scoring machine boost to team. Decent speed, he's got a good dribble stat. Vertical, it's all right. These are all gonna be boosted up. Rebounding is low, too low in my opinion. Inside offensive game is off the charts, and all those +6s are the boost he's given to himself as well as the other starters on the team. He has very good looking perimeter shooting stats, but the three-pointer as low as it is at 89 has meant for me that this card is not consistent shooting beyond the arc. Obviously he'll be fine with mid-ranges and that sort of thing. It's not that he can't hit a three, he's just not gonna be a consistent three-point shooter for you. Although I'm somewhat limited in the boost because I have four cards in here that have position boosts. Really good looking defense, good looking playmaking stats, and that is it, Jimmy Butler. So there's not much new to talk about in terms of the promo. GM sets still have not dropped. We're not sure exactly what they're gonna look like or how they're gonna work, but we have a pretty good idea. So no updates. So that means we're gonna go straight into some gameplay with our chemical reaction lineup. We're gonna go into showdown twice and we're gonna spread the ball around. What are my impressions playing with these cards a few times last night? Haliburton can sink the three. His defense is all right. Zach is an absolute bucket. He's also good going inside. He gets rebounds and he plays defense. Jaren Jackson Jr., he can get some rebounds. He has a nice one-handed slam going down the lane. He can hit the perimeter shot behind the arc, and he plays some pretty good defense. Clint Capella has been a rebounding fool for me. I mean, a rebounding fool. And his defense seems to be okay. And then that takes us to Jimmy Buckets, Jimmy Butler. I have not seen much rebounding with this card. He is an absolute beast inside. From the perimeter, not too reliable beyond the arc, but he'll be fine shooting middies. Pretty potent defense. But the way this Butler card shines for me is going to the rim, man. He has a whole host of dunks. You know the drill? Two times in showdown. We'll come back. We'll wrap it up. Let's get it. All right, just a 110 overall, but a multi-year lineup. They got Mutombo in there. Finals LeBron. That Luka will have a corner clutch three. There goes Zach. That's not his spot. So I don't know why we did that. But there's Capella getting the board, putting it in. Luka has a corner clutch three. It's going to be in the near corner. I do remember that. Nice interception by Zach. This is his spot. It's hot for him. Boom. He's a bucket. Kyrie cards are always fast, but Halliburton gets the steal. Very nice. We'll take him over to the wing, and boom. Pretty good start. Come on. Oh, come on. Oh, come on. That's a 94 Luka with an 89-3. Challenged? Come on. All right, Capella. Boom. Nice dunk by Clint Capella. We're trying to get everybody involved here. Come on. Good defense inside. Really nice. First Capella, then Zach. And then Capella got back for the board. All right, it's Jimmy Butler time. Finger roll, nice. Scoring with contact, no problem. We'll get some more Jimmy inside. We'll get some more Jimmy inside. Nice steal. Zach, just to prove a point, he is a bucket. You find his spot, he is a bucket. What are you doing, Kyrie? No way. Look who gets the board. Clint Capella wins the fight with Porzingis. Here we go. Come on, Jimmy. Let's go. 360. Boom. Nice. Very nice. Come on. Some defense. Come on, Halliburton. Wow. Kyrie was just hopping back and forward, back and forward, back and forward, and then he took one step to the right and he was gone. Jaren Jackson Jr., top of the key, he missed it. Who gets the board? Slams it back, Clint Capella. I told you this card is a rebounding fool. Come on. Shoot. I mean, Mutombo never moved a fraction of that fast in his life, and there's Capella again. Gets the board. Mutombo had position. Zach on the fast break. Slams it one-handed. Really nice. They're all looking very, very good. No way. Are you kidding me? Twice? Oh, man. Oh, man. Okay, hold on. All right. Come on, Jimmy. Make them pay for it. All right, we're going to have to take the buzzer beater. We don't have to take it with Jimmy, but we're going to. High risk, boom. All right, 24-8. You know, it is what it is. And now we get to go through a whole bunch of screens. 10 NBA cash, thank you. More. Don't hit continue, all right. Hey, nice job by Xavier playing way down and winning his drive, GG. All right, you know, this isn't fair at all, but I've been getting 102s, 104s. I even had a 98. So we're going to focus more on Jimmy this time. And that pretty much means going inside. Not total Jimmy gameplay. Like, we'll start off with Zach burying a three. Boom. But we're going to get the ball to Jimmy a lot more this time around. This Clarkson card, it's a pain for me. No way. Jeez. Capella, man. Capella, here we go. Jimmy. Boom. Beautiful. Windmill dunk. If Clarkson shoots, he almost always makes it. Ooh, that's two misses by KD. Here comes Jimmy. Baseline. Cradle. Oh my, that was a beautiful dunk. Uncontested, all the way to the rim. Wow. Come on, Halliburton, get the steal. There. Oh, nuts, they're scoring. Nope, KD is missing, so who got the board? Jaren Jackson Jr. for a change. Here he goes. Oh, that was just a power move. He just powered the guy out of the way. Wow. Jimmy Butler in the paint is a beast. Period. Oh, we switched just in time to draw that foul. Otherwise, it would have been a foul on us. about time to take one with Halliburton. Boom, rattles it in. Not the best release in the world, but it still counts for 3 points. There you go, Zach. There's that D. Let's go. Reward him. Boom. We have a huge overall advantage, and let's get it to Jimmy a lot more in these last 50 seconds. Nice steal. Where's Jimmy? There he is. Look out. Boom. Does the windmill from the other side. So we've had, nice. Get it to Jimmy. Take it. Nice little one-handed reverse 180 dunk. Man, I think we've seen them all. The 180, the 360, cradle, windmill. Uh-oh, we're gonna get a chance to see another one. What you got? Boom, tomahawk. That's the one we were missing. I mean, I'm not the biggest fan personally of Jimmy Butler cards, but this card is fun to play with if you want to take dunks. Oh, Clarkson buries a giant three. A giant three. All right, Jimmy, you got one in you? Boom, there we go. Inside out. Let's go. Can we get it back? Can we get it back? I'd like to get another dunk with Jimmy. Not gonna have enough time. All right, I think KD's gonna make that one. So Jimmy's in the near corner. Best we can do is try to get a catch and shoot three. Perfect release. Really no reason for that shot not to go in, but that's what I mean about Jimmy being inconsistent beyond the arc. The score is what it should be. And a great job by Dimitri playing down, way down, and winning his drive by three. GG. Okay, in summary, Jimmy Butler is an absolute beast inside. Now, with the 104s, obviously it's gonna depend whether or not you really want or need a 104 overall in your lineup with an elite position boost. But Halliburton, I mean, he hits his shots for the most part, and he has some D, but I'm not terribly impressed with his D. Zach LaVine is a really good card. Inside, outside, and defense. I don't know what more you could want. Whether or not you need Zach in your lineup, which is gonna depend entirely upon your progression, your overall, all of that. Zach's a pretty popular card, and I've had fun playing with him a few times over the last couple days. Jaren Jackson Jr., I think we kind of ignored him a little bit. But he can shoot from the outside, and he has a nice one-handed dunk going down the lane. It's hard to judge his rebounding playing up against Clint Capella because Capella grabs everything. Clint Capella, I don't know what to say. He just gets every board. I mean, that's pretty much what you just saw for two gameplays. That's been my experience with him in every gameplay. Of the 104s for Chemical Reaction, I put Zach and Clint way above Halliburton and Triple J. So good luck with this promo, man. It's a long one. Keep your fingers crossed we get some side promos, right? All right, well, it's mid-afternoon where I'm at and I haven't had an opportunity to eat today. So with that, it's over. It's done. We're out of here. There's no more. And as always, peace out.